The new Crown pneumonia epidemic in the United States has passed a severe milestone. The cumulative E number of confirmed cases in the United States exceeds 2 million, and more than 2 people have died from the new Crown. This number has surpassed the number of experts from the WHO House's new Crown epidemic response team predicted in March this year that 24 people will eventually die from the epidemic throughout the entire United States. According to the Daily Mail report, Columbia University's new Crown infection model predicts that there may be 36 million active SARS-CoV infection, which will cause another 9 million infections. However, the refreshed death numbers are not the end of the U epidemic according to the New York Times. With the surge in confirmed cases nationwide, the number of deaths is expected to continue to rise sharply. There were more than 9 new deaths in a single day in the United States on the 8th. Medical experts estimate that there will soon be 3 deaths in the United States every day, and more will die before the inauguration ceremony of the new president on January 2nd next year. A headline article in the Washington Post stated that since the beginning of the pandemic, some public health officials and politicians in the United States had hoped that the terrible lethality of the new Crown virus might unite the country to fight the virus, but the entire country has political and cultural differences. The profound division has enabled the United States to embark on a different path. The Trump administration does not care about the worsening epidemic since the election. Trump has been obsessed with accusations of fraud in the election, and has strongly prevented the government from cooperating with the Biden team. Not only is the PR president completely indifferent to the new Crown epidemic, but health experts have disputes about the severity of the epidemic, which is also one of the main reasons for the current out-of-control situation. Just looking at the current domestic situation in the United States, even the most optimistic people have to admit that Biden's statement that the United States is about to usher in a dark winter is true. Although the domestic epidemic situation in the United States is so serious, the U government has tried its best to contain China's development. Instead, it has continued to create anti-China remarks on a global scale, even resorting to deceptive diplomatic policies to discredit and slander China. But this anti-China strategy I have repeatedly hit nails, and most countries do not support it. This kind of clown political performance comes from a superpower like the United States.